the first thing I wanted to do was talk to somebody who has lived a life of a paraplegic. And I was fortunate enough to come across a gentleman named David Bryant. And David Bryant was paralyzed at 19. He's been paralyzed for the last 35 years. So he's lived a life. He's in his 50s, obviously. You know, a man like Ironside who remembers what it's like to be able-bodied, but has been living very comfortably now, you know, in a wheelchair. It is not a show about a man who is disabled. It is a show about a man who is brilliant at what he does. He's had to make some adjustments in his life. The specificity of the adjustment and the challenge is that he's in a wheelchair. It is that he had a spinal cord injury, but he doesn't let that get in the way. And to me, that's fascinating. I mean, you see in the opening of this pilot, he's jacking a guy up in the backseat of a car. And it's like Michael Calio, who wrote the initial script, said, "You listen, in the backseat of a car, whether you're disabled or not, everybody's equal." What makes it interesting to me, what makes this cop detective different than all the other cops and detectives we've seen before, it's how he processes things. It's how he navigates and learns and maneuvers the cases. Because, I mean, that, you know, week to week we have a different case. We have a different challenge before us to solve. This Ironside is based or inspired by the original Ironside, where Raymond Burr starred as Ironside. He was a chief of detectives and ran from 1967 to 1975. Now, the only thing we're really borrowing from that series is the fact that his name is Robert T. Ironside, the fact that he is a detective, he's a sergeant in our version, and he's in a wheelchair, as was the original, of course. When I signed up to do this, I know I was playing a guy in a wheelchair. I don't think I've been this physical in a long time, much more physical than I expected to be. He's a chameleon, you know, in a lot of ways. I like that. I mean, if he has to go hardcore, he can go hardcore, and we see that. If he has to be more intellectual about it, we see that he's a brilliant detective, investigative detective. What's interesting about Ironside is that he's learned that, you know, sometimes when you break the rules, not necessarily break the law, but break the rules, you get things done. And everybody in his team understands that. And he's training them in the same vein to do that. Not break the law, necessarily, but push the envelope a bit.